I started my business actually to fulfill a dream, which sounds really corny, but it's completely true. I've wanted to do this ever since I was a very little girl, and kept looking at it on the side as something to do and never really took the leap. And then one day, all the stars lined up and I finally saw an opportunity. And so I grabbed it. So after 20 years as a librarian, I made a complete jump and decided to do this instead. And I haven't looked back. It's interesting to see how people react, because there were people very close to me, especially in the library world. Librarians are not known to be big risk takers. So there was sort of an intake of breath and sort of a moment of, I want to support you, but I'm really scared for you, which I greatly appreciated because I felt exactly that way on the inside. I think it was just the initial shock of the complete change that really made people wonder if I had gone completely crazy. Support is so important for something like this. And if you ever want to take a big risk, you have to find at least one person who will just be your back and always be your cheerleader. But my spouse has been so supportive from the moment that I texted him and said, I'm going to quit my job and do this. And he texted back, LOL. And I said, no, really, I'm going to do this. And he said, I know you are. We'll talk about it tonight. So it was sort of that moment. So he has always completely believed in me. And in those dark moments where I might not completely believe in myself, or I might be really, really scared about a next step, about how things are changing, in those moments in my life, he is the one who then comes back and says, you got this. And sometimes you just can't do that for yourself. You need somebody. So I tell anybody who's trying to do this for the first time, make sure you find that one person that you can always count on, who will always believe in you, even if you have to say to them, hey, you're my one person. I'm always going to need you to be the one to say, even if you're completely honest and say, that was really stupid, but you can do it. Then you found the right person. And I'm very fortunate that as I've grown in my business, I've networked with other agency owners, other people who go through the same sorts of things. And so now when I have a little individual, how do I handle this? There's a network of people that I can count on to sort of pick me up and say, ooh, that was really kind of stupid there, but you got this. So when he's not available, then I know that I've got more people, but he is always the one.